It is really both an honor and a pleasure for me to say a few words on this occasion. The honor is because of our host, Mr. Lars Favos Andersen, who is Excellency the Ambassador of the EU, and to celebrate in this venue is really an honor. And the pleasure is to meet all of you, our scientists, who managed and succeeded in getting grants from the seventh program, framework program of the EU. I know that it is not an easy job, and I really congratulate all of you for succeeding in it. The special pleasure of me, as the president of the Israel Academy of Sciences, is to discover, I don't discover it, but I really rediscover it, the excellence mainly of our young scientists. I was so impressed with the results of the ERC starting grants. I know that you all know the numbers, but I'm not tired of repeating them again and again and again, because this is a tremendous success of the Israeli young scientist communities. As you know, this year there were over 3,000 applications to the EU for the starting ERC grants. Altogether, 289 succeeded and were approved. This is on the average 9%. Of those 289, 32 are Israelis. We are on absolute numbers, number three. Only, the first one is Great Britain with, or the UK, with 60 grants. The second is Germany with 46 grants. And Israel is the third one with 32 grants. Behind us are France, Holland, Switzerland, all the countries that are really excellent in science, they are behind us. On the average, our rate of success in Israel is 60%, ranging between 40% and 70% among the various higher education institutions. And I think that this is incredible. I can't get over it, because we are absolutely number one in this competition. I repeat saying to myself that if this achievement would have been in sports, the whole country would have been on wheels and exploding with joy. With science, everything is more subdued, but as the Israel Academy of Sciences, we know how to appreciate it, and really, kol hakavod to our young scientists. You really placed us. You won the championship, the European championship, and this is a very, very important achievement. Now, I can't finish without saying a few words about the Horizon 2020. I remember, Marcel, that almost a year ago, you convened a meeting of all the bodies that participate in the European Union scientific projects, the framework projects, to see if we can convince the government and all the governmental bodies to join the Horizon 2020, because it is quite an expensive project for the Israeli government. But everybody was so enthusiastic about it and so convinced that it is our place within this European community to continue and to collaborate. The collaboration is important because it allows us exposure of the Israeli scientists to the science in Europe, and the exposure of the Israeli science to the European scientist community. And because of this, I think it was the decision of Israel to join, and I hope that the difficulties that are now apparent will, you know, will be dissolved, so that we can repeat, because I want to repeat Professor Trachtenberg's remark. We have to be in the Horizon 2020, and I hope that this will materialize. So with this, I want first of all, or last but not least, to congratulate all of you. You are the ones who have made it, and we are very proud of all of you. The Israel Academy of Sciences is really very proud of its scientists that put us in a really respectable place on the European arena. So thank you, all of you.